Yes.
Does the U.S. approve of Turkey's development of forces in Iraq without the permission of the Iraqi government?
I think we've dealt with this, haven't we?
Do you approve of it? Does the United States approve of it?
I've talked about this several times this week. I'd refer you to the transcripts of the last two or three days, but what I can tell you just in short is that we want all counter-ISIL efforts inside Iraq to be done with the full coordination and permission of the Iraqi government. Let me finish. With the cooperation and the approval of the Iraqi government, as our military operations have been inside Iraq, and we understand that Turkey and Iraq are in a dialogue about this issue, and that we're encouraged by that, and we think that that's the right venue for this, is for the two countries to work this out bilaterally.
Well, in this case, it hasn't been done with Iraq's permission. So does this mean that you disapprove of what Turkey did?
I'm not going to take a position one way or the other on approving or disapproving. I've already said what our position is on counter-ISIL efforts in Iraq. We want all of those efforts by any country to be done in full coordination and with the permission of, the approval of, the sovereign government of Iraq. And we understand that this particular deployment this particular presence is something that the two governments are talking about, and by golly, that's the right way that this should be worked out. And so we're glad to see that.
Well, the Iraqi Prime Minister Abadi asked NATO to put pressure on Turkey to pull out the troops. Has the U.S. intervened in any way, and in what way?
The Prime Minister is the Prime Minister of a sovereign country, and I haven't seen that particular decision, but certainly if that's how he has decided he wants to pursue this, then those are his decisions to make.
Well, you're not offering any assessment of what Turkey did. You're saying words, but essentially the U.S. is silent on what Turkey did. Is the reason for this silence the fact that the U.S. is using the Incirlik base in Turkey and doesn't want to lose access to it?
Oh, so here we go. This is what you're really getting at. Look, nobody's being silent about this. If you'd been at the briefing the last several days, you would have seen, or if you looked at the transcript,
you would have seen.
I'm going to do one more time with you, one more round here, and then we're going to go to somebody else. You would have seen that I've been nothing but open and candid about our views about this particular troop issue between Turkey and Iraq. The United States has not been silent. We've not been silent one whit about it. And we believe, and I'll say it again, that this needs to be worked out bilaterally between the two countries. And our stance on that is because that's what we really believe. I don't know how many times I've stood up here this week and talked about bilateral relations between two different countries and the expectation that the United States ought to intervene in every issue between every two countries, I think is just completely ridiculous. So we want them to work this out directly, and they are, and we're encouraged by that. And it has nothing to do with the cooperation and the assistance that we enjoy from, the coalition enjoys from Turkey, whether it's Incirlik or the other cooperative efforts that Turkey is employing against ISIL. Okay?
Well, you're saying, that's right.
I think I've dealt with your questions quite
enough. It's a different question.
I want to ask about Yemen.
The peace talks in Switzerland. Is there going to be a U.S. presence or observing presence at the talks? And if so, who?
I don't have so this is the – hang on a second. I'll get there. Yemen's here somewhere. There it is. Yeah, so as I said the other day, we welcome the announcement by the UN Special Envoy for Yemen that all-party peace talks will begin on the 15th in Switzerland. As I said before, we urge all parties to avoid any further delays and to attend the talks in good faith and without preconditions. I don't have anything specific with respect to our participation. I'll have to take that and
thank you.
Get back to you.
Yeah. I have one more question on Turkey, please.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you. Well, you're saying that it's up to Turkey and Iraq to figure out the situation with the uninvited Turkish troops. But the U.S. does take upon itself to invite forces from other countries into Iraq and in Syria. Ash Carter was telling Congress yesterday that he personally reached out to 40 countries asking them to commit special ops for the fight and other support. The Iraqi parliament is concerned that their country is becoming this ground where different countries do what they want. The Iraqi parliament's Security and Defense Committee is calling for the review or cancellation of the U.S. security agreement with Iraq. What does the U.S. do to address their concerns?
Address whose concerns?
The Iraqi parliament Security and Defense Committee that is now calling to review or cancel the agreement with the U.S.
I haven't seen those reports, ma'am. We continue to work with the Iraqi government. The troops that Secretary Carter referred to, that decision was done in full coordination and cooperation with the Iraqi government. If you're trying to suggest that somehow U.S. military assistance against ISIL is untoward or being done without full coordination with the Iraqi government, it's just a completely baseless charge, and I don't think it's worth having any more discussions about it.
But are you saying that you're not aware of the Iraqi Parliament's this Security and Defense Committee's initiative?
I haven't seen that. I haven't seen that.
Okay. What the situation where the U.S.
I'm
going to
give you just
forces.
One more, honestly, and then that's it. Okay.
Sure.
Go ahead.
The situation where the U.S. invites forces to Iraq and the U.S. is leading this coalition, but when something goes wrong, the U.S. says it's none of our business, like with the Turkish troops, you have to figure it out between yourselves. Should it be of no concern to Iraq?
Should what be of no concern? I love these questions that are 10 minutes long, and then I'm supposed to get the grain of it out of here. Should what be of no concern?
The fact that when something, you have this cooperation, you have this agreement, but when something goes wrong, the U.S. says it's none of our business, like with what's happening with the Turkish troops.
Oh, come on. Again, another ridiculous question. When have we ever said it's none of our business?
You are saying that about the Turkish troops.
Well, no, I'm not. I'm saying that, I'll say it again, okay, we want this to be worked out bilaterally between Turkey and Iraq. And the way you're trying to twist all this around to make it look like we're doing something nefarious or that we're, you know, we've got some sort of inappropriate relationships here. I mean, it's just so silly.
Well,
and
I can't believe, honestly,
that you aren't embarrassed to ask these questions. You have to be looking at these questions and almost laughing to yourself, don't you? I mean, they're absolutely crazy. So we are working very closely with the Abadi government, right? We are working inside a coalition of 65 nations, 65 nations that have signed up to go after ISIL in Iraq and in Syria. Let me finish. You've had your moment. 65 nations. And what we have said from the very beginning, I said it when I was at the Pentagon in uniform, is that we want any action against ISIL inside Iraq specifically to be done with full cooperation and coordination with the Iraqi government and with their sovereign permission. That hasn't changed one whit. Now there's this dispute between Turkey and Iraq over the presence of a small number of troops, okay?
I said it
over the last several days, and I'll say it again. Nothing's changed about our position about the sovereign nature of Iraq and the fact that troops operating against ISIL inside Iraq needs to be done with the Iraqi government's permission, and we've stated that publicly. We've stated that privately to every member of the coalition. Nothing's changed about that,
sir.
And we want Turkey and Iraq to work this out, and they are. You are trying to find a way to make this some big divisive issue, and even the Turks and the Iraqis know that it's not, and they're working their way through it. So let's let them work their way through it and let the rest of everybody keep focusing on ISIL, which is what we should do, and which, by the way, the Russians aren't doing.
Should I not be asking what the U.S. assessment of Turkish actions is?
I'm going to take this one, Asha, then I'm going to come to you.
Should I not be asking that question? Exactly which question should I be embarrassed about, sir?
You can ask me whatever you want. I'm just stunned that you're not embarrassed by some of the questions you ask.
I notice that
RT very rarely asks any tough questions of their own government. So you can ask whatever you want. That's the beauty of this setting, right? here at the State Department, you can come in here and ask me whatever you want. And you can be as challenging as you want to be and accusatory in your questions. Some of those today, absolutely ridiculous. You can do that here in the United States, but I don't
Which
see you...
Which question was ridiculous,
I
sir?
Don't see you asking those same questions of your own government about ISIL in Syria.
Which,
and I
which
would
of
love
my questions
to see
was ridiculous.
Those questions get asked. Arshad?
I'd like to switch to just...